Welcome to We Are Society, a new show on YSTV where we talk about everything creative with the creatives themselves. Today we have Tash Crane with us. Tash Crane of Tash Crane Bags.
Hello.
Nice to see you. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm good. I just want to note first how we're wearing matching nails.
That's very true.
We just had to mention that.
It's very true.
Because isn't that amazing? Anyways.
Accidental slow.
But yeah. So you're here because not only are you a part of the Norman Ray Gallery, which is amazing. You're also a little entrepreneur.
Well,
owner and founder of Tash Crane Bags.
So
would you tell me a little bit about the Norman Ray Gallery and what you do there?
Yeah, so at the Norman Ray, I'm a gallery assistant alongside Pippa, love Pip, my right-hand man. So we're basically in charge of managing like the gallery space and sending back artworks after we've had exhibitions, managing when they come in, when they leave, just trying to maintain the gallery space generally so that we can put on events as best as we possibly can. So yeah, it's a lot of work, but it's really good fun.
Definitely is. I think it's really impressive, the Norman Ray, because it's the only all student run gallery in the country.
Yeah, it's the only like all student run gallery in the UK, which is like such an asset for York. Because I mean, it's one of the reasons why I chose to come to York in the first place. It's just so impressive.
It is. It's really good. And you put on quite a lot of events considering you are just like all students.
Yeah, all students. I mean, it's like a full-time job for, especially for like our four directors and stuff. So we do like two exhibitions a term, which is a huge amount of work because we're also coordinating like members and trying to get them involved with sourcing artworks and things. So it's like a lot of fun, really tight turnarounds, but it's really amazing. Like once you've got your opening night,
definitely,
you've opened it and then it's there for 2 weeks. And
It is. And the turnouts are always really amazing. Like whether you're doing like the gallery, the exhibitions, or you're doing the pop-ups or anything, like little things, like there's a lot of people there.
Yeah, it's always really fun to just see that as like a creative hub in York, that people are really interested in it.
Yeah.
And it just, it means a lot that people still continue to come all the time.
Yeah, you get quite a good mix of people as well. Yeah. Different kinds of art. Every time you do an exhibition, there's like a lot of array of things. It's like sculpture, digital art.
Yeah, I'm always surprised to see like how we can transform the gallery space actually, because we've had like loads of sculptural works in before, and then our first exhibition this year was Cash Money, and that had so much digital artwork in there, and yeah, we just completely transformed the space, and it's so much fun just seeing it all go up and come together.
It's
so nice.
It's pretty amazing. Yeah. How did you find out about the Norman Ray Gallery?
So it was I do history of art, so it was a big part of the admissions when we when I was looking at York as a university, because it's obviously a huge asset with this being so unique nationally. And I just thought like, what an amazing sort of opportunity to like get so hands-in involved with running something for students and like by students, because it means that you kind of have like a voice that's more or less uninhibited by the university, which is so rare, like especially in the art world. It's like, it's really difficult to find.
It is. Yeah, the fact that it's so like student run, that it's all like starts and finishes with students. Yeah. It's like, so,
and we're the people who know, you know, what is interesting like most for the student body and stuff. So instead of having, you know, sort of like grown-ups and faculty constantly speaking for you, it's so nice to be able to make something that speaks directly to you, and that you can introduce people that you know are like interested in this. And it's so much fun.
It just makes it like really good experience as well, because then if you go into the real world of like art and stuff, you actually have like proper first-hand experience rather than like another level being involved,
rather than just like shadowing people who put these things together. Like it is honestly, it's a lot of the work as a committee. We work almost like a professional gallery. We don't work in like a commercial capacity really, but like it's so much work. And
yeah, no, you really
alongside
do.
Alongside studying, I don't know how the directors do it, to be honest.
No, it is
impressive. I honestly don't know how they do it.
It's crazy, because I know you did you were quite involved with the pop-up.
Yeah.
Pop-ups that have happened, both of them.
Yeah.
And every time you're doing it, like, you're always like, there's so much going on. Like, it's so impressive how much you've got to think about.
Thank you.
But yeah, it's just like, the fact that you're doing it completely all yourself is really
impressive. It's so much organisation, but it really does... You know, it's really worth it once you just see
it's rewarding
people coming in. And I don't think anything like really beats that, to be honest. That sounds so...
No, it's true though.
When you're like super involved in it and then it comes to fruition, it feels so amazing.
Yeah. When was it when you first started like sort of enjoying art? Because like obviously you do art history.
Yeah.
So it's been a while that you've been interested in art. Not everyone is, so...
Well, I mean, I did art A-level, so I never really enjoyed art. Do you get what I mean?
Right,
it was
sure.
hell. But that's why I like art history, because you know, the pressure is kind of off this idea of you having to kind of create art. And I've always been more of somebody who's like appreciated it.
Yeah.
And I've always loved galleries, like grew up in London and, you know, it's all like at your fingertips and stuff. So, yeah, just having it, art spaces being social spaces and, you know, things that make you think so drastically differently, like all the time is so much fun. So
I mean, being in London's really helpful for art. It's like a centre hub of art.
Yeah, I'm really, really lucky in that sense. It's like, I think when I was sort of a young teenager, that was when I started enjoying like going to exhibitions and things. I remember like the Don McCullen Tate exhibition was one of the moments where I was like, oh, actually, this is a really powerful thing. I'd really like to see more of this. And that was when I was like 15 or so.
Yeah, I think that's why it's so important having things in other areas as well, like having like the Norman Ray in York for students, and like you can kind of spread that, because like a lot
to
of you aren't. Yeah, exactly.
From this place that's like so inaccessible. It's
exactly,
so inaccessible.
Exactly.
And like, you know, not everybody has like the funds to create exhibitions. So the fact that we can manage to do that at the Norman Ray and bring some of that kind of vibe and the essence of enjoying art and bringing together things, curating them, having like giving power to the fact that art can like communicate feelings and emotions. It can make you feel things.
Mm-hmm.
And so it feels so good to be able to put things together like that.
Yeah. I love that. So was it kind of a natural progression of like loving art to going into sort of like fashion stuff and like making bags and stuff? Tell me a bit about that.
I mean, like I said, I did art A-level, and that was...
That kind of ruined it a little bit.
Really not fun. And I felt like, for me, bags were... So when I started making bags and crocheting, I kept it as separate as I could from something like art A-level and this idea of creating art, because for me, it's just... I could basically make, like, a little brand and do... You know, still make art, like, branding and, you know, photographing it, doing photo shoots and things, like being really creative, but without this pressure. Like I was the only person who was in charge or critiquing it or saying, you know, what I could do better. And that meant a lot to me. So I just continued doing it honestly just for fun.
Yeah.
And like as a rest from from like A levels.
That is kind of the best way for it to go. It's like if it starts as an escape from something, it's a nice, like it's only sort of, you only associate it with like the good parts
literally.
Of that time.
Yeah, they were sort of saying in my art A level, they were like, why don't you put some crochet in here? And I was like,
no, you don't want to cross the streams.
I was like, crochet is a safe space.
Definitely. I mean, it's good that you started it then, because now you've got like, it's like you got a little evolving thing of crochet.
It's really fun, like having come to uni and sort of having a whole new group of people to kind of share bags with. I know it sounds a bit silly, but it's like, and they're people that I see every day, like It means a lot knowing that people are enjoying them.
Would you like to show off your bag that you brought with you?
Here's one I made earlier. Little Blue Peter moment. This one's very well loved. I'll explain.
Yeah,
them,
tell
like,
me a bit
a
about the bags.
Bit.
Go for
They're
it.
They're basically made from dead stock t-shirt fabric.
Mm-hmm.
So this fabric that doesn't get made into t-shirts. So either a company's gone bust or like, it's in surplus, gets stripped into long strips, and I crochet them into bags. So they're made from recycled t-shirt material, basically. So they're nice and like, they're not very stretchy. Ooh. Oops. They're not super elastic like a lot of other kinds of yarns.
Yeah, yeah.
But
It's amazing that you've been able to do it with like recycled materials. So it's kind of like, I mean, carbon neutral is a hard, like,
difficult to get.
But you know, the fact that you're like creating something in the fashion world that's not feeding into like fast fashion and kind of like, you know, disposable kind of things like that.
That was the reason mostly why I like continued to make bags and things, was because I was sick of seeing, you know, buying a bag off ASOS and then seeing another girl wearing it like 2 weeks later and being like, oh, maybe I'm not as unique and special as I thought. And it's like, it's increasingly difficult to, I think, do that in our world today. Like, trends come and go so quickly.
It's
that
true.
If you find one thing that you resonate with and find expressive, you know, someone's told you that it's done.
Within not very long. Yeah.
So I love that, like, making something myself and being able to then make my own clothes and things like that as well, because it's a skill that means you can make your own stuff.
Yeah, I know, it's amazing, and it just gives you that sense of like individuality, and I like that. But it does. But like, even with other people, because a lot of people now, like, you see, it's kind of, I mean, you've been here in second year now, so I've been selling bags in York for a little bit, and like, it's kind of funny. Every time there's a pop up, well, there's been two so far. You sell out so quick.
No.
She makes like 15 plus bags and they all
I'm
go.
Like up until like 3 a.m. crocheting them. Like,
she is. You watch like really bad films
to
get
watch
through.
Like awful Netflix films to get through it. What was it that I was watching that was awful? Oh, I had to watch loads of Emily in Paris to get me through. Like,
I just had to watch Emily in Paris.
I couldn't watch anything good. Yeah. It just had to be mind-numbing. So I could focus on
You need like the background stimulation, but nothing too interesting.
Nothing too interesting. Just something plain, like a plain like bagel of a show. Like,
true.
So that you can, I don't know, focus on something else.
Yeah. But yeah, I like, and as well, the I didn't realise this for a while, but the yarn that you get, you sort of request general colours.
Yeah.
And then you kind of, they kind of give you a mixed bag, so you don't know what you're going to get each time.
It's so fun because it means that, yeah, I can request like blue shades. Sometimes they're more specific, like light blue shades or something, or brown shades. And sometimes I just get sent the weirdest colours. But it's really great because it means you never know what you're expecting. And it's always like a little challenge. Yeah. I feel like the people that I get my yarn from have like sent me a little challenge. Yeah, and I'm what am I going to make with this?
And it's cool because then you've still got that like staple of the Tash Crane bag. Like, it's recognizable, but like, they're
it's
all
the
different.
New Birkin, babes. It's the new Birkin.
New Birkin, babes. It really is. So, yeah, I love how you've got that crossover of, like, the little fashion world. What are your thoughts on, like, the way, like, fashion and art kind of cohesive? What are your general thoughts on how it's going these days?
I mean, like I was kind of saying, it's really difficult with trend cycles being so fast and, like, TikTok throwing things in and then throwing things out and then... you know, I think that the art world is, you know, obviously like a lot more stable in a way, but it's so inaccessible. Like, it's why it's so nice that the gallery allows you to get so hands-on with like putting together shows, is that you're not restricted by like this commercial capacity of it has to be profitable or it has to speak to this audience because this audience is what's kind of trending. And in that sense, like, the kind of fashion and art is kind of similar in that you can find things that people are always trying to resonate with a certain group of people the most. And I feel like having a community that you're so immersed in as a student means that I feel like the gallery stuff here always hits the nail on the head a bit. It's so I'm not going to say easy, but it just feels really great speaking directly like to the community you're part of, instead of constantly reaching out to, like, I don't know, impress a really niche group of people that don't even really exist.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't know. Yeah. I don't know if that makes sense or not.
No, but I know what you mean, yeah. Is it like, I don't know, there's a lot of like, obviously like ethical issues in like the fashion world these days. I don't know, it's hard. Do you find it hard to like still be inspired by it and everything?
You're worried that, you know, I love flicking through like Vogue runway on my phone and stuff, and you're like, this is so amazing. And then, you know, you look at like archive runways and things like that, but then you go, oh, but if I'm going to contribute to this in any substantial way, it means you have to kind of play along to their rules, which is, you know, rules of overconsumption and things, which is really horrible, because I think on everybody's mind, like, is the environment, which is why it's nice that with knitting and crocheting, if you don't like something anymore, you can unravel it.
That's true.
And you can make it into something new. It's just, it sometimes is, remembering that is so
Yeah.
Like, inspiring.
Like, the nature of it is quite, like, reusable and recyclable, which is, that is really fun.
Yeah,
I think it's really good that you are, like, that's kind of, like, part of the imperative. It's kind of fun.
Yeah.
But what do you think is, like, the future of Tash Crane bags?
Oh, big question. Honestly, I just keep doing them for fun.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like the reason why I started making them is still so true, which is that they are so relaxing to make, and I love that every one of them looks different and that I can give them as gifts to my friends.
Yeah.
I can sell them on the side if I want to, but that it will always be like a nice little side project for me that I'll always be able to enjoy.
Yeah.
So I'm just hoping that I can like stay fulfilled with it and, you know, make something new and, you know, all the time and be fulfilled.
I mean, it's
that.
Definitely like giving you a new skill set as well.
Yeah.
Like, and you've definitely like obviously improved over the years and like
definitely.
You can make more interesting things that are like different patterns and stuff.
But like doing commissions and things, like you gain skills of like communication and stuff and negotiation. And I'm like, oh, okay, I need to put this all on my CV. But it's tricky.
How to fight with a Depop girl.
No, literally, basically. So I was featured on Depop drama. Like,
oh my God. Wait, were you really?
No, I wasn't.
Oh my
God.
I wish.
That's
like,
well, I hope not.
That's the day that you've made it if you're on Depop drama.
No, for real. Yeah. I just think like it's kind of difficult having that confidence in something that you've made yourself to admit that there are skills in it that you can legitimize and stuff. But
yeah,
you know, if like, I don't know, if a man had an entrepreneurial little spirit, he would do it.
It's true.
Is what I'm saying.
So true.
This is legitimate.
It's so legit.
It's legit to me.
What would you say have been your favorite parts of being involved with the gallery, or like, what's been your favorite thing to do?
I have loved like every exhibition and opening night is so much fun. I love like the after parties and it's like a real celebration of you've looked at the art, you've seen everything that you've worked towards. Like Cash Money was amazing.
Mm.
That was so much work to put in, and it was just such like an innovative idea, and I really felt like the gallery was utterly transformed. Like, it was so cool.
Yeah.
And then we just had Queer, which we're deinstalling on Saturday.
Queer was so good.
Queer was amazing. Just like the kind of more personal interaction with it that I think a lot of students got and communicated to us, and it meant a lot to be able to represent like a community in York that is definitely like underrepresented and still face so much, you know, trouble within York. Like, York is backwards in a lot of ways.
Mm-hmm.
And I just think being able to celebrate like the queer community and have a space that was really uplifting and celebrated queer talent, it was really so much fun, and I'm really proud of us for creating that space and being the ones to do it, because like, kind of who else will, unless you do, like, if you've got an idea for it, like, it means so much to be able to just execute what you want. And it was the first exhibition of its kind that was solely dedicated to the queer community, so it was so great. Yeah,
it is really good, because then you can sort of like, the gallery allows like so many different kinds of people, and it's just like, it's a creative space, so it just like, it just invites like expression of so many different people, and it's like, it's easy to get involved with the gallery as well. Like, you just need like a membership.
Yeah, you just need a membership, and you can come along to meetings on a Wednesday, and you source artists, and you help on install, and we do some socials and things like that. But
it's
like, you know, you're gaining like real skills on how to put on an exhibition.
It is.
Cool.
It is very impressive what the Norman Ray Gallery does, and it's also Tash Crane in general is impressive. Yeah. Should we plug? What do you want to plug?
What do I want to plug?
At Tash Crane Bags on Instagram.
At Tash Crane Bags on Instagram. Norman Ray Gallery on Instagram.
Norman Ray Gallery. It's just above Courtyard. If you want to see it in person.
Yeah.
We
have our exhibitions open for 2 weeks after we install them. Mm-hmm. So our next one, we're deinstalling Queer tomorrow, and then we're installing a new exhibition which is called Body Architect, which we've started working on now, and that's going to be our last one of the term and the last one of this committee as well.
Can you talk a bit about that, or are you not allowed to?
Oh, I can.
I wasn't sure. I was always, go on.
Body Architect is basically just an exhibition that's all about bodies, bodily interaction, you know, human to human, your space, your body, like in a space. It's kind of difficult to conceptualize with words, but it's it's going to visually be really beautiful, and we're looking at lots of sculptural pieces that we're hopefully going to get in.
That'll be exciting.
And yeah, I'm really excited for it.
Have you started contacting artists and stuff?
Yeah,
that's fun.
It's not got too busy yet, but it will get a bit more intense in the next like 2 weeks or so. Yeah. So come along to the next meeting.
What's when's the, do you have got a date for the next exhibition?
I'm not exactly sure when it opens.
Is it end of this term?
From the top kind of my head, but it's going to be this term. It's our last exhibition of the term. So come along, because it'll be a lot of fun. There'll be an after party as well. So
sounds amazing.
Yeah, to move your body.
Yeah,
body,
it's a groove.
To move your body.
That's great.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for coming on, Tash.
Thank you, Georgia.
It's been so lovely. Yeah, this has been We Are Society.
Very good.